When it comes to controlling boost electronically with an external wastegate, the three-port solenoid is probably the most common option you're going to see. And in most applications, that's going to be absolutely fine. What we do find, though, is that there is a limit to the range of control we can get or achieve with the three-port solenoid. This is because with the way the three-port solenoid is normally plumbed, we're always going to have boost pressure making its way to the underside of the wastegate. This boost pressure helps try and push the wastegate open. What this means is that if, for example, we had a wastegate spring fitted that gave us a 10 psi base or minimum boost pressure, we may find that with the three-port solenoid maxed out at maximum duty cycle, we may only be able to raise the boost up to perhaps 20 or maybe 25 psi. And again, that's probably fine for most applications. In a situation, however, where we want to get a really wide range of boost control, this may not be adequate. If we wanted to be able to achieve a minimum boost pressure of 20 psi, but perhaps a maximum boost pressure of 35 to 40 psi, we simply wouldn't be able to get there because we've still got that boost reaching the bottom of the wastegate, trying to force it open. Of course, when the engine's at high RPM and high boost, we've also got exhaust back pressure trying to force the wastegate open too. The option here is to swap out a three-port solenoid for a four-port solenoid. The way this solenoid works is that it can completely remove boost pressure from the underside of the wastegate and instead just supply it to the top of the wastegate. In this situation, we've still got that exhaust manifold back pressure trying to force the wastegate open. However, now we've got boost pressure trying to force the wastegate closed. This gives us that wider range of boost control. This is really important in some situations, such as high-powered drag cars, where we need to be able to leave the line with relatively low boost to achieve low power and make sure we've got traction. However, at the deep end of the drag strip, when we do have more traction available, we can then wind the boost up to make a lot more power. If you want to learn more about electronic boost control and external wastegates, you can check out our boost control tuning course at hpacademy.com/courses.